Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Come on, give God some praise on this wonderful day. Glory to God. This is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad therein. I am truly excited on this wonderful day. This is a special day of my life. Glory to God. I thank God for life today. I thank God, glory to God, for he is a God, glory to God, that always been with me from day one, glory to God. I praise the Lord today, my brothers and sisters, glory to God. I am celebrating life. I'm celebrating life in Christ, glory to God. I'm celebrating King Jesus. I'm celebrating the Lord of Lords. I'm celebrating the great I am, glory to God. He is an awesome God. He is a way maker. Do I have a witness out here? He is a miracle worker. Oh, yes, he is. You're looking at a miracle right now. You're hearing the voice of a miracle. Glory to God. He is the promise keeper. Glory to God. He is the light in the dark places. Hallelujah. My God, glory to God. That is who he is. He is the great I am. I am celebrating, glory to God, the King of glory. Hallelujah. I love the Lord. Because he first loved me. Anybody want to give God a praise right where you are? Because this is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice in spite of glory to God. I shall rejoice and be glad therein. Come on, give God a praise in the name of Jesus. He's an awesome and mighty God. Hallelujah, glory to God. He's the great I am. Hallelujah, glory to God, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. He's the author of my life, glory to God. He writes the chapter, the final chapter of my life, and I come to give him glory. I come to give him honor. I come to give him praise. I'm so grateful. I'm so thankful, glory to God. Gratefulness is in my heart this morning. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Bless everyone in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. At this time, we're going to have overseer to take us to the throne room of grace. Glory to God.
Good morning, everybody on Facebook Live. And good morning to everybody on the conference call.
Yeah.
Let's pray. The eternal Father, most holy Father, we come to you once again just giving you thanks.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father, once again for another day of being amongst the land of the living, for waking us up in our right state of mind and giving us the use and the activity of our limbs, for forgiving us of our sins, anything we said and did was displeasing.
Thank you, Jesus.
But most of all, we thank you for
glory to God.
Now, Heavenly Father, we lift up the shepherd of the hour.
Hallelujah.
And know that you have still a word in her, Heavenly Father, for your people.
Yes.
And we ask that you anoint her from the top of her head to the bottom of her feet, Heavenly Father, that she bring forth your word.
Amen.
And we pray someone will receive your word on today. In Jesus' name, we do pray and give thanks. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Come on. Don't stop praising God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I thank God. I bless him. I give him the honor. I give him the glory. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Everyone that's on Facebook Live, everyone that's on the conference call line, this is truly a wonderful day. Although maybe cloudy on the outside, but there's a sun shining on the inside. Do I have a witness in the name of Jesus? Glory to God. Today's celebration is in order. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because we all have life and glory to God in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. And I come to realize today is a glory to God is a gift of life from God himself. I'm so excited. Glory to God. Today is my birthday. 61 years. I give God the glory. I give him the praise. I give him all glory to God. All that belongs to him on this wonderful day and every day of my life. I thank God, glory to God, that I'm 61 years old. And I thank God that I still got my mom, glory to God. And that's a gift right there in the name of Jesus, glory to God. But I come to realize, glory to God, that today, glory to God, hallelujah. Today I've been living for 61 years, 22,070 months. 95,956 weeks, 671,695 days, 16,120,687 hours. Glory to God. 967,241,205 minutes. Glory to God. 58,034,472,270 seconds, glory to God. As of midnight last night, glory to God. So I give God, that's a lot of hours, a lot of seconds, glory to God. A lot of days, glory to God. A lot of weeks, glory to God. And sure enough, glory to God, 61 years. I give God the glory, and I give him the praise, and I give him all the honor in the name of Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah, glory to God. But like I said earlier, every day is a gift from God. You and I, glory to God, we have the right to celebrate. We have a right to celebrate no matter where we are in life. We have still have a right to celebrate because we have a right, glory to God, to abundant life, glory to God. But I want to take you, glory to God, to our scripture today and grab your sword, the spirit, which is the word of God, and turn with me to the Gospel of John, the Gospel of John, chapter 10, verse 10. Very familiar passage, glory to God. But I think it is fitting for where we are, where I am for today, glory to God. The Gospel of John, chapter 10, verse 10. Hallelujah, glory to God. Thank the Lord, I bless him, I praise him. And it reads as follows. The thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. The thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. May the Lord bless the hearing, the understanding, and the interpretation of his holy, magnificent word. Amen. Glory to God. Bow with me as we go to the throne of grace just one more time. Father, we thank you and we bless you for this wonderful day, Lord God. This is truly a day that you have made, and we're going to continue to rejoice and give you all honor, all praise in it, Lord God. Father God, we thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your unfailing love, Lord God. We thank you for being the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords over our lives, Lord God. We thank you for giving up for your Son, Jesus Christ, to die on our behalf so we may have everlasting life. We thank you, Jesus, for giving up the Holy Spirit. And Holy Spirit, we thank you, glory to God, for being our advocate. We thank you for being our comforter. We thank you for being our revealer. We thank you for being our guide, glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank you for giving us peace and joy in the midst of all things in the name of Jesus. And Father God, hallelujah, bless your word today, Lord God. Let it not fall on deaf ear, Lord God, but let it encourage your people today. Let it refresh them. Let it revive them, Lord God. Give them a new mindset in the name of Jesus. Let it reinforce them, Lord God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. And we give you the praise and the honor, Lord God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let your anointing flow through the airways today, glory to God. Let it flow through the internet services. Let it go flow through Facebook Live and the conference call live. Let there be no interruptions in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody will be saved. Somebody will be delivered. Someone will be set free. Someone will be healed in the name of Jesus. Somebody will be revived. Someone will laugh again. Someone will live again. Someone will smile again in the name of Jesus. And we be sure to give you the honor and the glory. Hallelujah. In Jesus Christ, I pray. Father God, I take my seat. You stand up. Stop the gifting inside of me, Lord God. Let the anointing flow, Lord God. Let my cup run over, Lord God. In Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen and thank God. Come on, give him some praise. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But I want to use glory to God. I would like to use the title for that scripture alone, glory to God. And the title is Living an Abundant Life. Living an Abundant Life. Glory to God. And I just, glory to God, I just want you to speak to yourself and tell yourself, glory to God, I'm going to live the best days ever as of today. I'm going to live the best days ever, ever, as of today. No matter what I'm going through, no matter what I'm faced up against, no matter, glory, how I feel in my body, no matter, glory to God, what's happening all around me, no matter what, glory to God, in this environment of the COVID-19, I'm still going to live the best day ever in the name of Jesus. Every day I'm going to enjoy that day. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Because I come to realize that every day is a gift from God. And you and I have a right to celebrate. We have a right to live an abundant life. We have glory to God. God has endowed us with the ability, glory to God, hallelujah, to prove that he has a purpose for our lives in the name of Jesus. This is the time, my beloved brothers and sisters. This is a time to bloom. It's a time to blossom. Glory to God. It's a time to grow in your grace, in the knowledge of Jesus Christ. It's time, glory to God, to grow in the life of Christ in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. So I'm so excited, hallelujah, for what God has done. Glory to God. But as glory to God, today is my birthday, as I mentioned, glory to God. And this is truly a day that reminds me of God's care for my life. It is impossible to have a birthday and not to be reminded of the dependency of the Lord Jesus Christ for every day, dependent on his life-giving care. I can't survive, glory to God, without him, glory to God. Today, I'm so grateful to having the opportunity to express my appreciation to God for the many blessings that I receive each and every day. Even in the bad times, hallelujah, it was still a blessed day because God has kept me in the name of Jesus. So my question to you today, are you enjoying your life, glory to God, or are you having a hard time dealing with life? Are you enjoying your life, or are you having a hard time dealing with life, glory to God? I truly believe that through the power of the Holy Spirit, that we can enjoy everything in life. I really believe that, hallelujah, glory to God. Even when Satan tried to rob you, even when Satan tried to destroy everything around you, even when Satan tried to go and kill everything about us, glory to God. Hallelujah. And I know, have you ever had anything stolen from you? Glory to God. And I know as a result, glory to God, as that might have felt the Satan. And then this verse, this chapter 10, glory to God, it said the thief. And what John was saying, that glory to God, he was talking to the people of God. And he was telling them there's a thief out here, glory to God. And the thief, glory to God, was the false prophets. It was the false teachers that tried to persuade the people, glory to God, a false doctrine, glory to God, about Jesus Christ, the death, the burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. So glory to God. So he was talking about, glory to God, there's a good shepherd, but also there's a false shepherd. There's a good shepherd, but also there's a false leaders, glory to God, in the houses of God in the name of Jesus. And he called them thieves because they try to rob and try to steal the people of their salvation. They try to rob and steal them of their joy or eternal life, glory to God. And so, glory to God. So we said Satan come to steal, kill, and destroy. But the word of God said the thief come. But the thief is motivated by Satan. The thief has been influenced by Satan to destroy and kill the people of God. Glory to God. Because you know what? He don't want our cars. He don't want, glory to God. He don't want our careers. He don't want our homes. He don't want our relationships. He don't want our money nor our honey, glory to God. He wants to rob us of the joy of Jesus Christ. He wants to rob us of our peace, glory to God. He wants to rob us of our hope, glory to God, for eternity. He wants to rob us from prosperity, of the wholeness and the well-being, the totality of our being, glory to God. He wants to rob us from the successes that God has in store for us, glory to God, in the name of Jesus. So here in this text, it tells us that Jesus came to offer us the fullness of life. Hallelujah. He came to offer us the fullness of life. Again, John 10:10, he said, I've come that they may have life, glory to God. He didn't say, I come that they may live. He said, I come that they may have life. It's one thing to live, but it's another thing to have life. You may be living, but without the life of Christ, you're just a dead man walking, a dead woman walking, glory to God. So he said, I come that you may have life, glory to God. And the character of life is a growth. It's a change. The character of life is the ability to reproduce. The character of life, glory to God, is one having to breathe, glory to God, as Christ's breath is inside of us, glory to God. The character of life is to respond to the environment, glory to God, instead of just laying down and acting like, glory to God, you all dead and you like just a zombie, glory to God. The character of life is also producing offsprings in the name of Jesus and build them up in Christ. Hallelujah. The character of life is also being active, glory to God. Have a use of energy in the name of Jesus. I don't know about you, but I thank God that he came to give me life. And he just didn't come to give me life. He came to, glory to God, to have it to the fullness of life, glory to God. So here Jesus starts out by talking about the thief who is Satan. And as Jesus reveals what Satan wants to do to us, he wants to steal us, glory to God. He wants to kill. He wants to destroy, glory to God. So you see here the digression here, glory to God. He wants to, first of all, glory to God, he wants to steal, glory to God. He wants to steal our joy, glory to God. He wants to steal our love. He wants to steal our peace, glory to God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Then he wants to kill. He wants to kill our dreams. He wants to kill our visions. He wants to kill our hopes, glory to God. He wants to kill, glory to God. He wants to kill us in the name of Jesus. But not only that, he wants to destroy. He wants to destroy our soul. If he could get to our soul, and in our soul is our mind, is our emotions, glory to God, and our will, and our intellect, and our reasoning, glory to God. If he could kill our mind, kill our soul, glory to God, then we could be destroyed in the name of Jesus, glory to God. Satan wants, glory to God, he wants nothing to do, glory to God. He wants us to have nothing to do with the things of God in the name of Jesus, glory to God. Satan wants to completely to destroy our soul. And he wants us to rot in hell with him and his demonic forces and his demons. That's what he wants us to do. He's after us. He wants our soul. Stop crying about he's after your marriage. He's after your job. He's after your finances. He's after your children. Go, yeah, he is after our children, believe me. Because if he can't get to us, he'll come after the children. But ultimately, he wants the souls of God's people so we can rot in hell with him and his demons in the name of Jesus, glory to God. Satan wants nothing but evil for us. He has one goal, and that is destruction. But be encouraged, my brothers and sisters. Jesus is our good shepherd. He has saved us. He has saved you. He has saved me. He has given us abundant. The word abundant means plentiful. It means, glory to God, the fullness. It means richly, glory to God. He has given us abundant, plentiful, a richness in life in him, in the name of Jesus. He will restore everything Satan has robbed from you and to teach you how to walk in the abundance of life which he has promised you. One might think having abundance of life would be about having a surplus of money, a surplus of things and materialistic things and careers and glory to God and achievements and great successes, glory to God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. That's what they may think. But the abundant life that Jesus promised in John 10:10, it's not about things. It's not about position status. It's not about degrees. It's not about your success in the world. Glory to God. It's not about all your accomplishments. Glory to God. It's not about your fame. It's not about none of that in the name of Jesus. Abundance, glory to God. It's not about what we have. It's not about what we could get. It's not about what we claim. But more abundance, glory to God, means to have a surplus, a super abundance, glory to God, of the things that represent God in the name of Jesus. It has an overflow, glory to God, of joy, an overflow of peace, an overflow of love, glory to God, an overflow of goodness and kindness, an overflow of self-control, self-restraint, glory to God. Hallelujah. It's an outpouring, hallelujah, of the Holy Spirit. That's abundance, glory to God. It's the outpouring in of the Holy Spirit. In Joab, we talk about Joab chapter 2. He said, I will pour out my spirit. The word pour is a constant flow. I will pour out my spirit on all flesh, glory to God. That's the abundance, glory to God. Hallelujah. If you don't have the overflow of the Holy Spirit, your things, your titles, your positions, your fame means nothing, glory to God. You just live it. But life comes from the Holy Spirit, who is life himself, that overtakes us and overshower us, glory to God. Can I get a witness in here? I thank God, glory to God. He came to do exceedingly, abundantly, and above that works inside of us, what we could even think or ask for. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So glory to God. So I want to be filled. I understood when David said, my cup run over. It's an overflow. It's a surplus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's like exceedingly, it's beyond measure. Glory to God. So the fullness that Christ, hallelujah, the fullness of life that Christ offered us is never short of his promises. It's never short of his blessings. It's never short of his grace. It's never short, glory to God, of his favor, glory to God. It's never short, glory to God, of the things that he has for you to do in the name of Jesus, glory to God. So abundant life refers to life in its abounding fullness of joy, abounding fullness of strength in the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. So when the storms of life came, I got the abundance of life inside of me that makes me stand firm and not be moved. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But he wants us to have the fullness of joy, the fullness of the strength of Christ inside of us, the fullness of the strength in our spirit, the fullness of the strength in our mind, glory to God, the fullness of the strength in our body. Abundance life teaches, glory to God, teachings that God is a good God who wants to bless people with, glory to God, with new, glory to God, with a new mindset, glory to God, with new revelation, new motive, glory to God, and most of all, with a new relationship with him, glory to God. You can't have an abundance of life without having an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus. So abundant life, glory to God, for a person begins with a new birth in Christ, glory to God. It's a relationship with Jesus Christ, glory to God. Hallelujah, glory to God. This abundance for us as Christians, fullness of life is not measured in the terms of having a good time in the world. It's not measured as terms of having fun. It's not measured as terms of living large, glory to God, or having wealth and prestige and position and power, glory to God, but measured by the fulfillment, glory to God, of the responsibility that God has given unto you. It's measured by the fulfillment of self-control. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And the rewards and the blessings that occur over a lifetime of pleasing God. That's the abundance of life. It's not found in having an overflow. Glory to God. The abundance of life is found in having an overflow in the spiritual things. Having an overflow, glory to God, in the things of God. Having an overflow in the spiritual blessings, not in the materialistic ones, glory to God. So ultimately, abundance of life is about what we receive as a gift from the Lord. And to live known as stewards. We are stewards of the blessings of God, glory to God. And these blessings, glory to God, that we receive, glory to God, is about giving it unto others in the name of Jesus. It's to share God's mercy, share God's grace, share God's love, share God's wisdom, share with others in the name of Jesus. That's when we could truly say that I have abundance of life, glory to God. That God filled me so much of the spiritual things that now I have an overflow, and I'm sharing the things in the spirit with God, people, in the name of Jesus. So let me just give, glory to God. You know, I was at my 3 points. Let me just give you 3 points, glory to God. I want to share with you what abundance of life meant to me in the word of God. Hallelujah. What living an abundant life in Christ is really all about. Are you ready? I got 3 points for you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Number one, abundance of life, glory to God, is about a liberated life. A liberated life, glory to God. That's what it speaks to me. It speaks to me as having a liberated life, glory to God. That abundant life is a freedom. In other words, that abundant life is a freedom in Christ. Glory to God. Christ has set us free from the slavery and the bondage of this world so that we could do amazing things for him. That's what liberated life is, glory to God. If you're still in bondage, you still, glory to God, is a slave to sin and a slave to, glory to God, to people and a slave to saints and glory to God. You don't have an abundant life in the name of Jesus. God wants us to live in freedom. In fact, the Bible says that freedom is a choice. You got to choose to be free in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You got to choose to come out that house of bondage. You got to choose to come out that unhealthy relationship that's killing you and destroying your mind in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. It is a calling on your life. How do I know it's a calling on your life? Because God called us out of dark. God called us out of dark. It's a calling. God called us. He's calling you out of that dark place in your life. He's calling you out of that heavy place in your life that terminating your mind. Glory to God. That terminates. Hallelujah. Tormenting your mind. He's calling you out of captivity into his marvelous light. God doesn't want you to live downtrodden. He doesn't want you to live in constrained people, manipulation spirit and controlling spirit in the name of Jesus. You shouldn't be going to God, under the spell of a witchcraft. And the witchcraft spirit we learned Friday night is anyone that's trying to manipulate you, control you, threaten you, and you fear to move, to make a move, glory to God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. That's not abundant life. God wants us to have an abundant life. If you're not living a full and satisfying life, it's not because God doesn't want you to have it. God wants you to be free from the pain. He wants you to be free from guilt. He wants you to be free from shame. He wants you to be delivered. Glory to God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. I come to realize that everyday problems of life can lead to stress. It can lead to exhaustion. It can lead to a spiritual burnout. Glory to God. Which would distract you from hearing the word of God, distract you from hearing God's voice, distract you, glory to God, and from following the plans of God that he has for you in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But you got to stand up and you got to declare the decree that God has set me free. I'm no longer a bondage to slave. I'm no longer bondage to sin. I'm not a bondage, glory to God, to addictions in the name of Jesus. That's what abundant life means. I'm living an abundant life because God set me free from anger. He set me free from depression. He set me free from the hand of the enemy. Glory to God. He set me free where no person controls me, manipulate me. I got one controller, and that's the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. I'm free from the approval of people. I'm free from impressing people. I'm free, glory to God, to do the will of God in the name of Jesus. I'm free to be different than the world. I'm free to be who God has called me to be. I am so free, glory to God. Hallelujah, overseer. I'm so free that I could be who I want to be even in front of my husband. Hallelujah. Some people, glory to God, are shameful to do certain things in front of their mate. But glory to God, I'm just free. It is what it is. I am who I am. Whether you like me, whether you don't, it doesn't matter. Because I'm living an abundant life of freedom in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Also, do you not know the worry about tomorrow is a trap, glory to God, from the enemy? It's a trap to keep you, glory to God, to keep you in bondage, glory to God, worrying about tomorrow. But Jesus sets you free. You no longer need to worry about your future because God is in control. He's sovereign. He's El Elyon, the Most High God. He watch out for his people. You don't have to worry about who's gonna be selected as the president, because we got an El Elyon who's higher than the president. He's the one that control our economic issues. God does. He's the one that control our health. It's God, not no president. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, that's the law of the land, but we got bigger than the law of the land. We are under not just the law of the land, but we are ultimately under the glory to God, the grace of God, the law, hallelujah, the unction of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. This dispensation, we are led by the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. And I thank God that I'm free. I thank God, glory to God, that God is in control and he's good. So the spiritual freedom that we are called from is not just on the outside, it's an inside freedom. Hallelujah. I'm free from the inside. Hear me, overseer. No more hurt. No more pain. No more disappointment. No more shame. Oh, what I was once shameful, God gave me honor for my shame. He gave me double honor for my shame. And I thank him and I bless him. I'm free, glory to God, to be who God called me to be in the name of Jesus. I had the ability, hallelujah, to choose to obey God, hallelujah, without anybody, without worrying about who's going to like me, who's going to be with me. I'm going to follow Christ. If I have to go by myself, if my husband don't go with me, so be it. If my children don't go with me, so be it. If my loved ones don't go with me, so be it. I'm free, hallelujah, not to be a people pleaser, but to be a pleaser unto God and to serve him with everything I got. Hallelujah. I'm free. And who the Son set free is free indeed. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. God has delivered me. He has set me free. And I come to realize, hallelujah, that when you have been set free, you have the authority and the power over what have been, glory to God, over what had once had you bondage. You cannot, glory to God, hallelujah, speak life over somebody's life if you have not been delivered, set free from it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have to be, glory to God, you will only have authority and the power over what you have been free and delivered from, what you have overcome in the name of Jesus. Then you can help someone else to overcome it. Then you can help someone to be free from it, glory to God. Parents, don't talk about your children because they're dipping it down in certain lifestyles. If you have not been free from it in the name of Jesus, glory to God. You got to be free first. You have to overcome it before they could even overcome it in the name of Jesus. So I thank the Lord and I bless him. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So it doesn't matter what situation that you may have. Glory to God. God could bring you out of it. He could bring you out of it. You trust him. Just trust him. No matter what you face, your response should always be, as Paul did in the book of Acts chapter 20, it should be, none of these things move me. Neither do I count my life dear to myself, so that I may finish the course with joy and the ministry that he placed inside of me, that I will receive the Lord Jesus Christ to testify the gospel of the grace of God. Hallelujah. So it doesn't matter, glory to God, what I'm going through. It doesn't matter, glory to God, how good to God, painful it is. It doesn't matter what the devil trying to put, glory to God, in my life. None of the things move me. I will not bow down to him. I will not compromise him to him. I will not serve him in the name of Jesus. None of these things move me. There's a ministry inside of me, and I'm going to finish this ministry with joy in my heart and peace in my mind. I'm going to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus, glory to God. So living a fulfilled life, an abundant life, is being liberated, glory to God, is living a liberated life, a life of freedom in Christ, in the name of Jesus, glory to God. No more worry, no more anxiety attacks, no more, glory to God, depression, glory to God, no more being bipolar, taking medication to sleep, taking a drink to go to sleep, taking a drink to escape from your pain, no more in the name of Jesus. You got to tell that devil, hallelujah, I've been set free. Get in your heart first. Get it in your mind. Get it in your soul. Get it in your spirit in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Stop bowing down to Satan. Stop bowing. Some of you, glory to God, have the enemy in your home and you bow down to compromise. The devil is a liar. God got life for you. He said, I came that you may have life and life more abundantly. But number two, glory to God, living an abundant life is number two, is a loving life. So the first one is the liberated life. The second one that God gave me is a loving life. What you saying, Pastor Brooks? I'm saying this abundant life is a life of love. Love by who? Your husband, knowing this, not just my husband. It starts with God first. Sunday school, they talk about love. But I love the Lord because he first loves me. I love him because he first loved me. I didn't love him first. He loved me first. While I was still in my sin, he demonstrated his love according to Romans 5:10. He demonstrated his love. But while I was still a sinner, he loved me and died for me. While I was still doing the worst thing out there, he didn't start loving me when I gave my life to him. He didn't start loving me when I accepted the calling on my life. He loved me when I was born, while I was in my mother's womb. Before my mother knew me, he knew me. And he loved me. And he packed my life out from the end to the beginning. He knew what I had to go through to be who I am today. And I love him, glory to God, because he came to see about me. When I thought my life was over, when I thought there was no hope in my life, when I was backed up in a corner, and I didn't want to, glory to God, face life no more. And he came to see about me. He picked me up, washed me down, gave me a new mind, gave me a new heart, gave me a new spirit, glory to God, and told me to get out there, hallelujah, and that thing that got you down, it may not change on the outside, but I did a change on the inside, and I love him, and I said, God, what I need to do, hallelujah, I heard on a Sunday school line, and they were talking about love, glory to God, and I heard one comment said that we only could give love, glory to God, based on how we could receive it, and that's so true. Many people can't love because they have not experienced and accept the love of God. It's not how you receive it from a human being, because a human being love is false at times. It has no frailty, but you got to experience the love of God. And when you experience the love of God, nothing else matters to you. You have no fear who will stay with you and who's going to leave you. You have no fear what you're going to say next. You have no fear, glory to God, because God's perfect love casts out fear. Glory to God. Living a liberated life is a loving life. Hallelujah. It's a loving life. 1 John 4:12. He says, no man has seen God at any time. If you love that we love one another, God dwells inside of us, and his love is perfected in us. Hallelujah. So when we fail to love one another, we end up miserable. Oh, you want to know why you're so unhappy? You want to know why you want a roller coaster ride? You up one day, down the next day. Hallelujah. You want to know why you're so unsatisfied? Hallelujah. You still got a new man and still unsatisfied. You got a new woman and still unsatisfied. You got a new house and still unsatisfied. You got a new car and you're still unsatisfied. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because there's a vacuum in your heart, that only God can fulfill. And he let that hole be empty on purpose in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I advise you to search for God's love. I advise you, glory to God, to look to God for the love that you need in the name of Jesus. Because God wants us, glory to God, to love one another and even our enemies. If God commanded us to love, that means he had equipped us to do so. Hallelujah. But you got to open up your heart and let the Holy Spirit pour God's love into your heart. You can't do it based on your own ability, based on your own strength. That's the only way you're going to be able to love those that mistreat you. That's the only way you're going to be able to love your enemies that lied on you and hate you. In the name of Jesus, you got to open up your heart. Hallelujah. And let the love of God. Hallelujah. If you know how much God loves you, then you will show that same love towards others. I realize that you can't love because you never experienced and you never came to realization how much God loves you in the name of Jesus. I know you think your blessings came because of what you did and your hard effort. I know you think your income came because of the good job you worked. I know you think that your decrees came because your own intellectual mindset, but I want to let you know it has nothing to do with you. It has all to do with the love of God that's on your life, because we deserve death. Look over your life and see the sin and all the lifestyles that you display. But yet God still blessed us. He still gave us favor. He still gave us spiritual blessings from high places. That's because he loved you. Abundant life is when you know how to love. It's a loving life, glory to God. It's a loving life when you're not afraid to love again, because glory to God, because you know that when you love, glory to God, it make you vulnerable for hurt, to be hurt, glory to God. Hallelujah. But if you want to be like Jesus, we got to love like Jesus, glory to God. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah. Because I come to realize God's love is powerful. You know what it does? Love, glory to God, will make you change your mind. When you said you would never do that, can I get a witness? Love will make you change your mind, the love of God. Love will make you apologize when you know you didn't do nothing wrong. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness in here? Yes, indeed. Glory to God. The love of God, hallelujah, will make you feed and cook for those that mistreat you. Can I get a witness? Yes, indeed. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The love of God, glory to God. Hallelujah. It's so powerful in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. It makes you love those. Hallelujah. Genuinely. I'm not talking about nothing fake. It makes you genuinely love those that did you wrong in the name of Jesus. That's what love does. Love has no limits. Love make you do good when the circumstances are bad. Can I get a witness in the name of Jesus? And as Christians, filled with the love of God in our hearts, yes, Lord God, you must be the bigger person. I hate to tell you, you probably wonder, why I always got to be the bigger person? Because God chose you and filled you with an overflow and abundance of his love. And when you have the overflow of God in your heart, hallelujah, you got God right there, the fullness of God, the fullness of the God here dwells inside of you in the name of Jesus. So let go of unforgiveness. Let go not talking to your loved one. Shame on you in the name of you, in the name of Jesus, and shame off of them in the name of Jesus. You can't be a big person with a small heart and a little mind and stinking thinking in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Because genuine love is when, glory to God, when you abandon yourself to those, glory to God, that have a need. Hallelujah. Genuine love allow you to abandon yourself to those that have a need. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You can't go to God. This true love is worth pursuing, and it should be expressed with passion, with holding nothing back. This true love should be expressed with passion. It should be a fire inside of you. It should be a warmth going to God, because you can say, I love you. But those that have a spirit of discernment, they know the truth. But when you have a passion and a warmth inside of you, other people could feel it, and they will catch on fire in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. I understand why people, when you preach or teach, and when you speak the word of God, nobody can't feel nothing. They don't catch on fire, because there's no fire inside of you. Fire spreads, and love is like fire, but water can't quench it. A strong fire that nothing could put out in the name of Jesus. I'm on fire over here, but I'm not burning up. You better tell yourself and tell the devil, I'm on fire, but I'm not being burned up in the name of Jesus. It's the fire of God that's inside of me. Hallelujah, glory to God. Because I realize if I can't love, I'm nothing. First Corinthians 13 tells us you can speak in tongues, you can have faith like the moved mountain, glory to God. But if you cannot love, you're nothing. You got the gift of prophecy, the gift of teaching and preaching, the gift of evangelizing. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! But if you cannot love, you have nothing, and you lack nothing, and it benefits nobody. Hallelujah! And not even yourself in the name of Jesus. But I'm so glad that I have the love of God in my heart, because I come to realize love always wins at the end. Love never fails. If you keep on loving God, keep on loving his people, you got glory to God, you will never fail in the name of Jesus. I love it in Romans 8:38, and it says, for I am persuaded beyond doubt that nothing, death, nor death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor anything, nothing threatening, things to come, no power, hallelujah, no height, nor anything else, is all creation, hallelujah, all creation will be able to separate me from the love of God, hallelujah, no trial, no heartache, no pain, no loss can separate me from the love of God. Sometimes you feel you are alone. Sometimes you feel that God don't love you because what you're going through. But that's a lie from the pit of hell. God loves you with an everlasting love, with an unfailing love. But he's a jealous God. And sometimes he will withdraw those things that are close to our heart so you can draw close to him It's a life that you are free, liberated. It's a life that you are loved. You are loved. And you grow it because you are loved. You show love. It's a loving life. I love all people. Hallelujah. No matter where I go, I love them all. And matter of fact, I love people so much, my enemies don't even know that they're my enemies, that I know that they are my enemies. People that talked about me, people that mistreat me, I still love them the same. I know you said some words about me. I know you, glory to God, you had lied on me. I know you don't like everything I say, but you would never know that I know all about you, because I'm still giving the fullness of God's love. Because when I mistreated God, when I smack God in the face, when I lied on God, he still loved me. And like I said earlier, you can't give out love until you first receive the abundance of God's love on your life. In the name of Jesus, good God Almighty, he's an awesome God. He's a mighty God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When I think about God, how much he loved me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I know my husband loved me, because he can't love me like God. And sometimes he get mad at me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes for a second, he may not speak to me, but God never gets mad with me. God always speak to me, no matter what I do to him. He never put me on call waiting. He never had a busy signal in the name of Jesus. He always, I'm always on his behalf. I'm always in his doors. Can I get a witness in the name of Jesus? It doesn't matter what my husband think about me, how he feel about me. It all that matter to me is what God feel about me. It doesn't matter how you feel about me. Oh my God, my creator, my Elohim, my bishop, my soul, the love of my soul, the ship, the captain of my ship. Long I know he loves me. That's all that matters. I'm living an abundant of life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Stop trying to please people. Hallelujah. Stop trying to do things that people, what you're doing, you know, it's not for you. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. But last and not least, glory to God. Hallelujah. Living an abundant life is not just living a liberated life. It's just not living a loving life, but it's also living a lifting life. A lifting life, glory to God. John 12:32 says, and if I be lifted up from the earth, I would draw all men unto me. The Greek, glory to God, word for lifted, come from the root word to be elevated. It's meant to be elevated. To lift up is to draw attention to, is to make obvious, is to make something visible, glory to God. So we need glory to God. If we live an abundant life, we ought to be lifting up the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. If we want to draw people, if you want to draw your unsaved loved ones and draw others, glory to God, to Christ, you got to lift up not your name. Get your name out the way. Stop telling what you have done. Stop telling about all your ministry and all your jobs and all your stuff. You better lift up the name of Jesus and tell what God has done. It's a lifting life, glory to God, in the name of Jesus. We need to lift up Jesus in our lives. We need to lift up Jesus in our actions. We need to lift up Jesus, glory to God, in the words that we speak, in the name of Jesus. The lifting up of Jesus, hallelujah, is demonstrated when Christ will be lifted up on the cross and died by a crucifixion. And at the cross, Christ set us free from the chains of sin. This lifting up of Jesus on the cross is the captivating influence that pulls the people's heart to himself. Stop telling what you did in life. You better tell them what Jesus did for them. You better lift them up when their head is hung down. You better lift them up when they're being beaten and trodden down. You better lift them up when they feel disappointed, discouraged, and tell them not what you did, but tell them that Christ died for them. They'll no longer deliver defeated life, a life of addiction. addiction, a life of sexual immorality, a life of glory, God, pornography, a life being abused, a life of alcoholism, a life of drug addiction, a life of depression, a life of bipolar, a life, glory to God, of anger and rage. In the name of Jesus, you better tell them what Jesus did in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. So we got to look at Jesus' life. And everywhere he went, hallelujah, he exalted and he encouraged people. I love it, glory to God. In Mark chapter 9, verse 27, glory to God, there was a young man who was stricken with issues. Hallelujah, glory to God. And God called him. He was dealing with a foul spirit. And Jesus, glory to God, took him by the hand and lifted in the roads. And what he did, he rebuked that spirit. He rebuked. He correct that spirit and let that spirit know you're in the wrong place. You occupy the wrong body here. And when he rebuked the spirit, he took him by the hand, overseer. He took him by the hand. And when you take somebody by the hand, I mean that you're helping them. And he lifts him up, glory to God. He knew the man couldn't get up by himself. Hallelujah. God called in the church today to lift up the brokenhearted. God called in the church today. God wants to use you in the name of Jesus, glory to God. When we encounter, hallelujah, the issues of life with others in the name of Jesus, we are to encourage them and to lift them up. Know this, that God's miracle includes you. Hallelujah. God's miracle includes you. You are a partner with God in the healing process. You are a partner with God in casting out demons. God wants to use you and dispel his glory on your life in the name of Jesus. He wants to use your hands. Hallelujah. He wants to use your mouth. Hallelujah. He wants to use your feet. Hallelujah. He wants to use your prophetic voice at a time that we're living in today. Hallelujah. Mark chapter 16, starting verse 18, and he tells them, glory to God, Jesus declared to us that these signs will follow those who believe. These signs will follow them who believe. I want to ask this question. Are there any believers on Facebook Live today? Are there any believers on the conference line today? Hallelujah. It is said these signs, casting out demons, laying hands on the sick, raising the dead. It is said these signs will be done by prophets and pastors or teachers or evangelists. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It said these signs should be done by those who believe in Jesus Christ. Does anybody believe that Jesus Christ can still heal? Does anybody believe that Jesus can still deliver and set somebody free? Does anybody still believe that Jesus can cast out demons, that he can raise people from the dead, that he can still speak life in somebody's dead situation? Does anybody believe that he can bring you out of darkness, that he can bring you out of depression, that he can bring you out that hellhole that you're living in? Does anybody believe that he can bring you and make you live again, make you stand again, make you rise again? Does anybody believe that he can restore your life back and give you something better than what you had in the first place? Does anybody believe, hallelujah, that he will protect you and lead you and guide you? Can I get a witness in the name of Jesus? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I don't know about you, but I believe that he can make you live again. He can give you life again. He can make you smile again. He can make you laugh again. He can bring back the joy and the peace. Matter of fact, he can restore all your life. Somebody better praise God for restoration. God restored unto you when you never thought. Glory to God. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. I love in Romans 8:18. He said the suffering that we now are, hallelujah, can compare, have nothing to compare to the great glory that will be manifested in us. Your suffering cannot be compared to what God has in store for you. Hallelujah. Somebody might give me praise, God, and thank God for your suffering, because it cannot be compared to what God is about to manifest in your life, in the name of Jesus. I know God used me, use my hands, use my feet. Send me, I go, God. Can anybody say to God, send me, I go, God. I preach, I prophesy, I lay hands on the sick, I cast out demons, I raise the dead, oh God. Send me, and I go, God. Make me, God. Use me, Lord. Use me. I'm not going through the suffering just like this. The devil not going to take me out just like this. If I got to suffer like this for Christ, I'm going to do the work of the ministry that he has called me to do in the midst of my suffering in the name of Jesus. Use me, Lord. Can anybody say, make me a blessing in somebody's life, God? I'm not going to concern about my stuff right now, but make me a blessing, God, in somebody's life. God will never send you anywhere alone. Did you not know that? God will not send you anywhere alone in the name of Jesus. He will send his angels ahead of you. Wherever you go, his angels are already there waiting on you in the name of Jesus. Don't be afraid to go in that courtroom. You're not alone. Don't be afraid to go in the doctor's office. You're not alone. Don't be afraid to go on that job that's hell. You're not alone. Don't be afraid. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When God sends you to dark places, you are not alone. Your angels have already gone before you in the name of Jesus. But not just that. God said in his word that he's a real God. He's in the rear. That means he's behind you. That means he got your back in the name of Jesus. That means that your past can't torment you no more. All the people that glory God that used to be with you can't torment you no more. In the name of Jesus, God got your back. He's protecting you from your past so it won't pollute your future. In the name of Jesus, you got to declare, I am not what I have done, but I am what I have overcome. In the name of Jesus, I am more than a conqueror. I am an overcomer. In the name of Jesus, your history does not take determine your history, does not determine your destiny in the name of Jesus. Matter of fact, because you experience the low places of life, that's who God looking for. God looking for people who was in the crack house, who was in the whorehouse, who was in the house that was drunk like a skunk, who was in the house, hallelujah, that was taking drugs. He looking for the cheaters. He looking for the liars. He looking for the fornicators. He looking for the unwed moms. He looking for those that aborted their babies. Those are the people, good God Almighty, that he's looking for in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because you have overcome those things, you will go back out there in the world now and help someone else to overcome that depression, that bipolar spirit, that schizophrenia, the worries. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, I thank God I'm an overcomer. It's time, y'all. Hallelujah. It's time to live a lifting life for Christ. Hallelujah. The word said, lift up your head, all you gates, and be lifted up, because the King of glory is coming in. Lift up your head. Oh, glory to God. The scripture tells us also to lift up your eyes unto the Lord, which comes all your help. Lift up your eyes to God and take it off your circumstances. And also the word tells us, lift up your hands and give God a praise in the midst of all things. Give him right now a sacrifice of praise, because in spite of what you have gone through, God still wants to use you in the name of Jesus. Don't abort your ministry. Don't abort the calling that's on your life. You don't have to have a title behind your name or in front of your name to cast out demons, to lay hands on the sick, to prophetic, Lord God, to preach. The word preach only means to share the gospel. The word preach means to speak out your mouth. There's somebody today that got a prophetic voice. God wants you to open up your mouth and use that prophetic voice, because what comes out of your mouth, it shall come to pass. Speak life over your children. Call them out of darkness into God's marvelous light. Speak life over your finances. Don't give up. Open up your mouth. Lift up your here. Lift up your eyes, lift up your hands, and give God some glory and give him some praise, because he kept you when you didn't want to be kept. He healed you when you thought you was going to die, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. He's the King of glory, the King of kings, in the name of Jesus. I don't know about you. Your weakness mixed with God's strength, hallelujah, is a partnership that could change the world. Did you just hear what I said? Your weakness mixed with God's strength is a partnership, supernatural abundancy that could change the whole world, in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. I thank God that he's going to put his glory upon you. Just say, God, use me. Here I am, God. Use me, God, in spite of my frailty. Still use me, God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So abundant life is a liberated life, a life of freedom. I'm not in bondage by no person. In the name of Jesus, somebody out there, I don't know who you are, but you are in bondage and you're afraid to accept it. But today, my brother or sister, accept the fact and say, I'm coming out. If you got to come out by yourself, if you got to come out with nothing to come out with, but you know you got God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, stop living that life of miserable. Hallelujah. Stop letting people control your household, in the name of Jesus. You are, you got the authority, you got the power to cast out demons, you got the authority, and you got the power to trample over serpents and over scorpions, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Be liberated. Live a loving life and live a lifting life. And as I close, live a lasting life. Abundant life is a liberated life. It's a loving life. It's a lifting life. And it's a lasting life. It's eternal life. It's not everlasting. The difference between eternal life and everlasting. Everlasting means that you could be in hell or heaven, and it's going to be everlasting. It means anywhere that you be, it's going to be forever. But eternal life means that you are in heaven. You're in the kingdom of God. You're right there with God. Glory to God. And Jesus came to give. And he didn't come to take. Glory to God. He came to give life. He didn't come to take life. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus. He came to offer life. And when we're facing the death sentence, glory to God, he came to give us life, to break the chains, to open up the doors. Glory to God. But it was more than just that. He came to give us life abundantly. It is life on a higher plane. That's what God's got. Eternal life is lasting life. It's life on a higher plane. He came to give us a life that is better than what we could ever imagine. He came to give us life that's better than what we could ever imagine. I know God's got over 30 years ago. He was a child, my childhood years, in my teenager years, in my young adults years, going through so much pain, so much hurt, so much anger, so much rage. I didn't know that when God came and gave me life, he rebirthed me in the name of Jesus. I don't just celebrate my physical birth. I celebrate also my spiritual birth. I got two birthdays that I celebrate. Glory to God. And when God came and gave me my new life in him, I was born again in him. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I didn't ever know that my life would be like it is today. I never know that God would restore and God would just give me a peace. I never know my heart would be so full of joy and peace and kindness. Glory to God. I never knew that God was going to save my household. He saved my husband. He saved my children. I didn't know, glory to God, that God was going to elevate me on my job for ministry, glory to God. I never knew my life was going to be like this, glory to God. I never knew me and my husband were going to pass the church of TIM ministry. It birthed out of our pain. Hallelujah, some of you want to birth ministry. All my ministry, TIM ministry, which is God's ministry, it was birthed out of pain. It was birthed out of brokenness. It was birthed out of torment. It was birthed out of torment. And I never knew that God was going to do something like this overseer in our life. Look at us now. We are miracles. Don't you dare envy us. Oh, what we have came. came through brokenness, what we have came through, glory to God. Hallelujah. Our pain and aches and struggles and problems in the name of Jesus. I thank God. Don't you dare, glory to God, dismiss your life. Don't you dare, hallelujah, waste your life. Don't you dare waste your pain. Don't you dare waste your past. God using it to bring forth something awesome in the name of Jesus. Can I get a witness? But what I love always seeing, glory to God, is that he told me, hallelujah, that my latter days gonna be much greater than my former days. Hallelujah. Somebody better praise God right now. You haven't seen nothing yet. You thought your former days was something. But when your latter days, God said it, that it's gonna be greater than your, glory to God, your latter days gonna be greater than your former days. You asked Kayla that was in the promised land. Hallelujah, was one of the original ones in the beginning. And when he went back in the promised land for 40 years, he came out the promised land. Hallelujah, 82 years old in the name of Jesus. And Joshua didn't give him no land to possess. And he went to Joshua. He said, wait a minute, brother man. Don't let my age fool you. Don't let my age fool you. I can still possess the land that God promised me. Don't let my body fool you in the name of Jesus. And he said, look, brother man, I'm stronger, wiser, hallelujah, than I was 40 years ago. I can handle this like never before. Can I get a witness? Don't let your age, hallelujah, stop you from doing the work of the ministry. Stop you from fulfilling your promises in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God is our good shepherd. He's our resurrection. He's the resurrection and the life. He's the truth, the way and the life. He's the revealer. He's the savior. He's the bridge over troubled waters. He's the captain of our ship. He's the bread of life. He's the root of the son of David. Can I get a witness? Hallelujah. I give God the praise. I give him the honor. I give him the glory. In the name of Jesus, he said, he who believes in me, though he may die physically, but he shall live from everlasting. I thank God. I got life more abundantly. I got a liberated life. I got a loving life. I got a lifting life. And I got a lasting life, which is eternal life for Christ. Hallelujah. By believing in him, I know that I would never experience a separation from God. That's abundant life. I would never experience a separation from God. He will always be with me. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. So Jesus wanted nothing but the best for us. And first he come to bring us life. And Jesus came down the cross that we should have eternal life. But not only did he come to bring us eternal life, he also came that we would have the fullness of life here and now. Is there anyone out there right now, glory to God, in the sound of my voice, and you've been going through for a long time, you've been depressed, you've been trying everything in the world, all different relationships, the drinking, the partying, the wild parties, glory to God, hallelujah, jobs, careers, money, investments, but you still got a void inside of you. You still unsatisfied. But God said, if you could open up your heart, and you may be a believer, but you're still in bondage. But God said, today, open up your heart and let me give you a new heart. He's knocking at the door of your heart if you're an unbeliever. Open up your heart that God come in. The money not going to satisfy you. The materialistic things not going to satisfy you. The fun, the pleasures of the world not going to satisfy you. Because if you be true in your heart, when you all alone, all by yourself, late at the midnight hour, you crying out to God. But God said, you will sincerely give up everything and don't take it back. Just leave it at the altar right where you are. It's the altar right in front of you. And you can say, just God, here I am, God. Take my heart. Take everything of me, God. And even you, some of you are believers, but You haven't given God everything. You haven't surrendered all to him. God said, I'm going to use you in another way. I'm going to use you in a mighty way. Give it all to God. Take it, God. And those of you that want to accept Christ as your Savior, say, Lord, come into my heart. I confess my sins. I come to a place of repentance. I believe that you are the Son of God, that you are the only one that's able to change my life. Nobody else could do, because I tried everything, but nothing else works. Now come into my heart, Lord God. I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. I accept you as the Son of the living God. I give all unto you in Jesus' name, I pray. And you shall be saved. If you believe in your heart, confess with your mouth, you shall be saved in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Go with me for a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you. We bless you. We praise you, Lord God, because you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Lord God. We thank you for this life that you have given us here on earth, Lord God. We thank you, glory to God, because there's a sound of abundance of rain that's coming our way, and we know that, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have changed us, Lord God. We thank you that we are free, and who the Son set free is free indeed, Lord God. Thank you for teaching us how to love your way, Lord God, because we only love based on someone else doing for us, Lord God. We only love based on our emotions, but Lord God, we choose to be free today, Lord God. We choose to love today, Lord God. We choose to lift up our head in the midst of what's going on around us, Lord God. We choose to lift up our hands, Lord God. We choose, Lord, to praise you, give you a sacrifice of praise, Lord God. We choose to lift up our eyes up to the hill, which come all our help, Lord God, knowing that we depend solely on you. Lord God, we not depend on no job, no promotion. We not depend on no man, no woman to take care of us, Lord God. We not depend on no doctor, not even the scientists for this COVID-19 cure, Lord God. But we lift up our eyes unto you, Lord God, because it's only going to come through you in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Lord God, help us, glory to God, to be people to be used by you. We want to be a blessing to somebody. We want to be used in this dark world because we know the time is short that you are coming back, Lord God. And you're coming back for a church about a spot or a wrinkle, Lord God. And we want to be ready for you. And we want to work until the day come of your return, Lord God. Father God, help us to realize that what we're going through cannot compare to the glory going to be manifested inside of us, Lord God. Are we stronger than ever because of our pain, our suffering? We better than ever, Lord God. We're going to live a better life, Lord God. We're going to live the best days ever, Lord God, starting today in the name of Jesus. Know that you are with us, Lord God. And we thank you. We bless you. And bless those that are sick in their body, Lord God. Heal them, Lord God. If anybody out there on the sound of my voice, they're sick, just lay your hands on your body right now. Know that God has given you the power and authority, glory to God, to heal in the name of Jesus, glory to God, because you're a believer. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, help us with the gift of discernment to discern demons inside of our homes and in our lives, Lord God, and let us cast them out, Lord God, and they shall not return, Lord God. Father God, bless those that have loved ones in the name of Jesus. They have lost loved ones, Lord God. Comfort them, Lord God. The God of all comfort them in a mighty way. Bless this world, Lord God. Show your face as we go out there and be the light in this dark world, Lord God. And we love you. We bless you. We praise you, Lord God. Bless those that have a need financially, Lord God. Meet their need. Give them their daily bread, Lord God, each and every day, Lord God. And I thank you for that, Lord God. I thank you for restoring families back. I thank you for restoring somebody's life is being restored right now. God has restored back unto you. You never thought your life would be like this. But give God some praise and give him some glory. And those of you that's waiting on God, just let you know, I hear the sound of abundance rain. According to 2 Kings, glory to God. According to 1 Kings 18, when Elijah said, I hear the sound of abundance of rain. And when you use the word rain in the Bible, it means the blessings coming down from heaven. Get ready in the name of Jesus. Don't get discouraged. Don't give up hope. Just bless his name. And Father God, we give you all the honor, all the glory, all the praise. In Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen and thank God. Come on, give us some praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, today is our first Sunday. So therefore, glory to God. I hope you are ready for our Holy Communion in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Grab your substance. Glory to God. The fruit of the vine. Hallelujah. the bread of life in the name of Jesus, whether you use a piece of bread or a cracker. It doesn't matter whether, glory to God, you have juice or not. Glory to God. God's not looking at the substance that we're taking in, because what defiles a man is not what comes in him, but what comes out of him. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. I thank you. I bless you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You want to bless overseer the Holy Communion? We're going to have overseer to bless. I hope, pray over our Holy Communion.
Right, let us pray. Dear Eternal Father, most Holy Father, come giving you thanks.
Yes,
we ask, Father, that you would bless the communion. We ask that you bless the bread that represents your body. We ask that you bless the fruit of the vine to represent your blood.
Yes.
But most of all, Father, we ask that you forgive us of our sins.
Thank you, Jesus.
Anything we said and did was displeasing in your eyes.
Yes, Lord.
As we give you all honor and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Come on, glory to God. Take your bread, glory to God, or your cracker, glory to God, in the name of Jesus. And this is a time, glory to God, in the book of John, the Gospel of John, the same gospel, glory to God, that Jesus, from the verse from chapter 11, after this chapter, chapter 11 to chapter 17, he in the upper room in Jerusalem, glory to God, the night of his crucifixion. And he told his disciples the things going to happen, glory to God, his birth, his resurrection, glory to God, in the name of Jesus. And he told him, he said, let not your heart be troubled. He said, if you believe in me, believe in God. Glory, if you believe in God, believe in me. He said, my Father's house has many mansions, glory to God. And I go and prepare a room for you. And if I go, take the if out because he's gone. He said, I'm going to come back to receive you unto myself. Glory to God. So don't be discouraged. Jesus is coming back. You can live your life as if he's not, if you want to. But he's coming back like a thief in the night. Hallelujah. You better make sure you're in the spirit. And you better make sure you're in a state of repentance. Because if not, you're going to be left behind. I hate to tell you this. Glory to God. But he's coming back for a church without a spot or a wrinkle in the name of Jesus. And so he took the bread from the table and he told him, he said, take, eat. First of all, glory to God. What he did, he blessed it, he broke it, and he gave thanks to the Father. Glory to God, your brokenness is blessed. Glory to God. And then he said, take, eat, for this is my body, which is broken for you in remission of sins. Let us eat. Glory to God. Praise God, glory to God, the same table, glory to God. He said, as often as you do this in remembrance of me. Remember what? Not just my burial, my death, not just my burial, not just my resurrection, but you better remember that I'm coming back. I am coming back, glory to God, like a thief on the night. I'm coming back, glory to God, on a cloud. The same way I left, I'm coming back again. Glory to God. Then he took the cup. He said, drink, for this is the blood of my new covenant, which is shared remission of many sins. Let us drink. Thank God that he allowed us to be partakers of another holy communion. And this holy communion represents that our sins have been washed away. It represents the healing of our body. It cleanses us. It purifies, glory to God. So I pray, glory to God, that you didn't take this lightly. That I pray the glory to God, when you took this Holy Communion, we are partakers. We eating Christ's flesh and we are drinking his blood that was shed on Calvary in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Don't forget Wednesday night. We start a new series Wednesday night. Meet me on Facebook Live, conference night, 7:30 with this Wednesday night. Glory to God. Thursday night is our intercessory prayer at 7 p.m. You can call our intercessory prayer line. Amen. Glory to God. Friday Night Live, you don't want to miss. We had an awesome discussion about what does God say about Halloween. It was an awesome discussion. So come on back and join us this Friday night at 7:15. Glory to God on our conference call line only. And then, of course, next Sunday, hallelujah, Sunday school at 10 o'clock from 10:45, Sunday service at 11 a.m. Amen. Glory to God. So I thank God. I want to just say, I thank you for all the love that you have shown me for the month of October, giving me many calls. I received many gifts. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Many monetary giftings also for Pastor Appreciation Month. I just want to say, I do appreciate you. I don't take it lightly what I receive, because when I receive, glory to God, I receive the love of God through you in the name of Jesus. thank you all for everything you have given me, many flowers, glory to God, many trips over my house. Glory to God, you thought, glory to God, between Friday and yesterday, you thought that I was having a birthday drive-by. So many people came by, drop off gifts and flowers, and I just want to say I love you all. I'm so grateful for what God has placed the people that he has surrounded me with in the name of Jesus. I would ask for a better group of people, glory to God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for all the birthday, glory to God, cards and gifts also in the name of Jesus. But those of you that said, man, I forgot to do anything for Pastor for her birthday. As you all know, I just don't celebrate my birthday for this one day. Good, I'm the beginning and I'm the end. The bottom line, yeah, overseer. Glory to God. I'm the beginning of the month, so therefore, all month long until the end of the month, I'll be celebrate my birthday. So you have many more days, glory to God, to celebrate with me or to drop off a gift if God places it in your heart. But the greater gift that I could receive from any of you is the gift of love, and I thank you for that in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you also for your give lift and your tithes and your offering, your building fund, your love offering to the pastor. I give God the praise and honor for you. Please continue to give, because we still got a home that we got to take care of on Allentown Road in Temple Hills, Maryland, that we got to still meet our financial obligations in the name of Jesus. Amen. So you be blessed, be wise, be encouraged today. Glory to God. Be free. Walk in your freedom. In the name of, don't let nothing discourage you. Don't let nothing, glory to God, hallelujah, glory to God, take your mind off of the things of God, and especially off of the love of God. Amen, glory to God. God bless you. Have a wonderful and blessed day in the Lord, because I'm going to continue to celebrate in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless.